Praise be to the name of the living God for the grace the Almighty God has given to us to meet again on these dynamics of God's word. I pray that the Almighty God will speak to you today. He will enlighten your eyes of understanding in the knowledge of his word, and your life will not remain the same in the name of Jesus. By the grace of God today, I want to share with you on the need to have an understanding to make adequate provision for divine intervention. There is need for you to make adequate provision for divine intervention, because all of us who are Christians, we pray that God should intervene in the affairs of our lives. But God will not do more than the provisions we make. If you don't have enough to receive, then God will not waste what he has. So every Christian, you are expected to make adequate provision for divine intervention, because God will not pour into you more than what you can receive. Let's go to the word of God. In Luke chapter 5, we want to consider from verse 5 to 7. Luke chapter 5 from verse 5 to 7, see what the Bible says. It said, "Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught." You see, Peter was a fisherman. He had toiled all the night trying to catch fishes, but he couldn't find any until the daybreak. And so in the early hour of the morning, Jesus came to the seashore, and he needed a ship to preach, through which to preach to people. And Peter offered him his ship. And after Jesus finished his ministration, he now told Peter, he said, "Draw, let down your nets for a draught." He said, "Let down your nets." When you look at the word net there, it's not just singular net. He was talking about plural one. He said, "Let down your nets." So Jesus believed that while Peter was coming for his fishing business, he should come with multiple things to receive. A lot of people, that's why we talk about multiple streams of income, multiple source of blessing and all that. So Jesus expected Peter not to come to the fishing, sea with just one net. So he told him, he said, "Let down your nets for a draught and see what Peter did." And Peter first complained that he had labored all night and he caught nothing. He said, "But notwithstanding, because you have spoken, I have no option but to do what you said." So Peter now decided to let down his net, because maybe he came with just one net. When Jesus had an expectation that you come with more than a net, he came with one net, and he dropped that net into the sea. And then what happened? Look at verse 6 now. He said, "And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net break." What Jesus had in mind to give to them, their net was not enough to contain them. So when Jesus saw that the blessing is getting to a point of breaking net, he had to stop it. You remember the story of the woman, the widow woman, whose two sons were to be taken to captive. And Elisha told her, he said, "Go and gather vessels not a few and begin to pour the oil." And then when the vessels were all filled, the oil ceased. So the miracle the woman received was a function of the number of vessels he had. So in this case, Peter had just one net to work with. And when the net got to a breaking point, Jesus had to see the miracle. But see what happened in verse 7 now. He said, "And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sink." Then my question is this: what kind of net is that? Peter came with such a big net and a strong net that could sink two ships. Let's say, for instance, Peter came with just a small net. Then he could have gotten a miracle limited to the size of the net. But Peter came with a very big net that could sink two ships. But remember, he came with one ship. I don't know what he had in his mind. I don't know his thought. Peter came to the fishing sea with just one ship, but he came with a net that was big enough to carry fishes that could sink two ships. Peter had a vision. He had a vision of expansion, vision of enlargement. He was not a man with a limited expectation. He had a great expectation, though he labored all the night and he caught nothing. But when Jesus came into his business, the size of the net determines the size of the cash. But don't forget, the cash was big enough to sink two ships. My dear viewer today, what level of provision are you making to receive what God has in mind for you. I want to tell you, as a Christian, the Bible says you are heir of God and joint heir with Christ. So everything God has belonged to you. But God will not give unto you more than the provision you have made. What Peter got was a function of the size of his net. What that widow woman got was determined by the number of vessels he had. What provision have you made? Are you expecting something big? It is your provision that will show your expectation. I pray the Lord will help you. Yes, your beginning might be little. You may be in a small size now. Don't belittle yourself. Prepare as if you have the whole world ahead of you. Prepare as if God, who is leading you, who is directing the affairs of your life, can do all things. Don't limit God in your life. As a Christian, your senses cannot carry you to where God wants to take you. Have a large heart. Believe God for the impossible. See God as doing things that no man can do. I want to tell you, my dear friend, your expectation will determine what you will receive. That woman with the issue of blood had an expectation that if I can touch the hem of his garment, I'm going to be healed. And what she expected, she got. She was not the only one there, but she was the one who determined. Remember that sick man whose four friends took to where Jesus was? When they got there, they saw multitude that was too big for them to break through. What did they do? They went to the top of the building and broke off the building and brought their friend down. Because they had a great expectation. They knew that if you could bring our friend to Jesus' presence, then his problem will be solved. My dear friend, come to God with great expectation. Make great provision for the miracle you are waiting for. And I want to tell you that with God, there is no level you cannot reach in life. In your business, in your career, in your ministry, there's no level God cannot take you. But you have to make adequate provision. You have to learn, you have to study, you have to pray, you have to do what you are expected to do so that God can see you as a worthy vessel to receive, because he won't do for you more than the provisions you have made. I pray the Almighty will help you. Let's pray. Father, I thank you today for the way you have sent across to us. And I thank you for this, my viewer, who is watching us from wherever you are watching. I pray that the Lord will open your eyes of understanding to know that God has great plan for your life and to make adequate provision to receive them in the name of Jesus. And whatever you are going through today that is not convenient for you or that is not comfortable, I decree today by the authority in the name of Jesus that the hand of God will come upon you and bring you solution in the name of Jesus. I speak to that body that is sick. You are healed in Jesus' name. I speak to that troubled home. Let the peace of God come to your home in the name of Jesus. In that your career, you will succeed. Thank you, Father. And the grace to walk with God until you get to eternity with him, may God grant to you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. My dear friend, I love you. And Jesus loves you. We want to bless you. By God's grace, we are still going to meet again on this platform. Until we meet again, continue to walk the victory of the cross. In the name of Jesus. Amen.